All right. Hello out there. We're going to do a little streaming tonight. Stream some VFR. It's too nice everywhere else. Everywhere in the PilotEdge area, it's nice weather tonight. So when you can't get bad weather, then that's a good sign you need to do some VFR. So we are sitting here at TVL, Lake Tahoe, on the network. And I've got some FS Economy legs to run in the Carinato Commander. So we'll be up to Reno, probably back to Tahoe at some point, and then we'll see how we do from there. I'll show you the my map overlay is back working again. Hooray. So we're here at TVL, right on the south edge, south end of the lake here, and we'll go up to Reno, which is very, very short flight. Reno is currently, as it often is, pretty windy, so we'll be landing to the west, probably on runway 25, is what I'm planning. So we'll go northeast out of Tahoe, and then kind of we'll wind our way through the mountains here and over towards Reno. But yeah, got our trusty commander that we've been spending some time in here. I'm enjoying the heck out of this plane. And that should be about all there is to it as far as the warm-up. I have a couple other things to talk about, some announcements to make and so on. We'll wait until we get up in the air for those. But yeah, let's go ahead and close the doors and get rolling. FS Economy's up. Passengers are in. Fuel is on board. Make sure we have enough fuel. Won't take much. But let's get a battery and some avionics. All right, yeah. Fuel-wise, we should be fine. Right there, so. It lights up a little bit, not too much. Position and beacon, come on. Cabin fan can come on. Open our window for now. And let's tune. Let's grab the NorCal frequency. Looks like 119.2. Oops. Get that over here so you can see it. We'll put it down here. That's a good spot for it. All right. 19.2. TVL has no tower. Reno obviously does, but it is not the current PilotEdge bonus field. So we will be essentially treating it as if it is untowered. And we are VFR today. So let's set our transponder while we're thinking about it. Here we go. A little more panel light. Be good. Pito Heaton, come on. Go ahead and get the boost on for the left side. Mixture to full rich, give it some throttle, parking brake on, and start it up. Much better. Okay. Engines are good, passengers are loaded, fuel's loaded, transponder is set, lights are good. I'm gonna grab the CTAF for Tahoe. 1227. Oops. We need to set our altimeter. We'll do here in just a moment. The altimeter at Tahoe is 3037. Freaking guy says that's not how you spell Reno. I screw something up. Oh, ha! In the description, you're correct. That is not how you spell Reno. I will fix that. I know that too. Oh. I think we have overriched our engine. Off to a good start here. Interesting. Let's see if I can restart him here. Do we have a failure? They both quit at the same time. Always a good sign. Engines. Everything's set to always working. This is the Carinato Commander 500, and it just did a thing that I've never seen it do before, where both engines just turn off. We are very high. We're at 6,000 feet, so it's possible.
Yeah, 919, contact Denver Center, 118.57.
They restarted, okay. Strange. Yeah, I suspect the mixture might have just been too rich, so I'll back it off a little bit here. Turn the boosts off too. Oh, too much. Boy, we're having fun today.
Air 919, Denver Center, descend via the Eldora to arrival to Denver altimeter 3018.
Alright. There we go. Better. Let's make sure it can hold it idle for a little bit, but I leaned it out quite a bit, so that should be better. Alright, I'm going to use the GPS as backup just in case we get super duper lost. I think we're good. Tahoe winds are calm. Weather's amazing, as you can see. We want to depart runway 18. So I'll switch over to the CTAF. Oh, we need to do our flaps. Look at our trim, make sure trim's good. Yeah, trim's fine. Alright. Leave the window open for now. Yeah. Lake Tahoe Traffic Commander 171 Zulu is taxiing for departure runway 18 Tahoe. Right, let's roll. Now, normally we would call up Reno approach pretty soon after we got in the air, but because Reno is not the current bonus field, there's no tower there. So I think, I actually don't know, this is kind of embarrassing, but I don't actually know how it's, how Keith intends for it to work with bonus fields that are not currently in operation. I don't know if the overlying approach is staffed or not. I suppose we can call them and find out once we get in the air. But in the meantime, we can. Yeah, the Tracons aren't active. That's what I work. That's certainly the case for towered fields that are not ever active in the Western expansion, like Medford or Boise. Places that have Tracons that we are not ever going to use because they're not active, those are not active. But I don't know about Reno, because it technically has a NorCal sector. We can call up and ask once we get air morning. Close your window. This is runway 36, not 18. I said the wrong thing earlier. It sounded wrong at the time, but I just went with it, which was silly. Yeah, Spokane's definitely not going to work, because Spokane is not an active field ever. Or active tower, I should say. Lake Tahoe Traffic Commander 171 Zulu is departing runway 36 to the north, Lake Tahoe. Alright, back to NorCal. Quiet night on the old stream tonight. That's okay though. Mostly I just want to fly some FSE legs and I figured y'all can come along for the ride on this. Watch me fail to successfully start engines, or more accurately, start them and then lose them. So easy to fly. Okay, gear up. I'm working on a video review of this plane. I just finished doing all the footage for it, all the in-sim video, and now I just have to record all the voiceover, and I'll have that published. But yeah, I want to experiment with doing more. More content created specifically for YouTube. So it's not all just live streams. People like the live streams, people watch them, but I want to make shorter videos where I actually think about what I want to say in advance. Just for change of pace, I guess. But yeah, we will head. Let's see, altitude wise, we should be fine. Around 9,500, so we'll get up to there. Beautiful weather right now. Go outside for a little bit since we're just VFR. But yeah, on a day like today when there's no bad weather anywhere in the PilotEdge service area, it's a good day for some VFR. So. We'll go up to the north end of the lake and call up the NorCal sector and see if he wants to talk to us. Climbing about 100 knots here. Looks good. Flaps are in, gears in.
Yeah, 919, contact Denver, approach 1-2.
I'm going to turn up the ATC just to scooch. And yeah, altitude-wise, we should be fine around 9,500. Shouldn't take too long. Just a little more.
Air 919, Denver approach, good ILS 1835, left approach, Denver altimeter 3018.
It's still really quiet to me. It's not as fun if you can't hear the ETC. Not as fun at all. Let's slow our climb a little bit here. I've been to Lake Tahoe, but I was a kid. I don't really remember it. But I've been flying. I've flown into Tahoe a couple times in the sim now in the last couple days. And it really makes me want to go back. It's just, it's pretty darn good looking from the air. But we're still climbing. Yeah, I saw right before I started. Oh, weather update there. Keep an eye on that. Still looks fine for VFR right now, but nothing like watching the visibility dive to make you reevaluate plans.
Alaska 511 Phoenix Lance, clear to the Denver Airport. You're outside the parts of the upper transition. Then it's filed. Climb via.
But what I was saying is, I noticed right before coming on the air that OBS has a new major version update, which includes a whole bunch of new features for audio and plugins and audio monitoring and all sorts of cool stuff. So I didn't feel like messing with it tonight.
Five, let me back here.
But that all sounds pretty interesting to me. All right, so I want to try and sneak through this little pass here, I think. And then we'll kind of, once we're around this little ridge, we should be able to turn north again without having to climb too much higher. So basically sneak through here and then north from there before we run into this ridge line. Reno's kind of tucked in around mountains on all sides. So NorCal Approach Commander 171 Zulu's over Lake Tahoe on our way to Reno. Do you want to talk to us, or is Reno Tracon offline?
Tracon's offline.
All right, thanks. Well, that answers that. No approach service on the way in, which is fine. That's one of the reasons I wanted to do this VFR anyway. It doesn't really matter. We don't need his help. We'll do it our way. Safely get over this ridge here. Yeah. Park back in. That peak right in front of us is at 10,700. So Reno's only at 4,500, so I don't want to get too high because we just have to go back down again. there's no bad weather, there's nothing to be done, as Kleistad said in Discord. But get up and look at Ortho. He was right. So that must be Carson Airport over there. CXP. Yeah. I think that's Carson. Not been over there yet.
Total go 50 Zulu Bravo contact NorCal approach 119.2.
And yeah, in real world, Reno has a Class Charlie from surface to 8,400 around it. But as I said earlier, it's not the current bonus field, and we just talked to NorCal and made sure he didn't need to talk to us, and he said nope. So we are on our own. Alright, go ahead and start descending again now.
Yeah, NorCal approach, Chieftain Charlie Golf, Zulu Bravo, we're 11,000.
Got a convicted Zulu Bravo, NorCal approach. What about the Reno weather and say approach request?
I'll go ahead and look up the weather and get you back.
Someone else going to Reno, but they're IFR. Interesting. Right. Now we should be able to head basically north-northeast and get there. Just about. I want to kind of approach it from the east anyway, since we'll be landing runway 25. So. Come back down now. Grab a better VFR altitude. So it's right there. We're going to land runway 25 because that's what the winds are currently favoring. But we'll be listening for that other airplane that's on approach. And hopefully not interfering with their plans too much either. Lights can come on. Everything else looks fine.
Okay, 919, contact Denver Tower.
So, because Reno is untowered, the CTAF is the control tower frequency, which is 118.7. So, we'll get that ready.
Air 19, Denver Tower, 3-5 left, clear to land.
There is a peak east of the airport at about 7,000 right here. Which is like this little ridge line here. So we'll fly a fairly close pattern here for 2-5. Or at least we'll try. If it doesn't feel stable, we can always change our plan. We're going to be landing far before someone who's on an approach, so I'm not too worried about that other traffic. I'm just going to go ahead and bank out now and continue on descending. Basically, I'll just try and turn in before this ridge line here. Should be reasonable. Slow way down, though.
And we'll cut departure. Charlie, go fix his little brother. We have the weather for Reno, and I really don't mind what approach. Dealer's choice if you want to just set us up for anything that you'd like.
Should I go fix the Bravo Sagan blaster?
Just set me up for any approach that you'd like. I really don't mind. Just a dealer's choice.
Should I go fix the Bravo? Honestly, I'd rather give you the visual unless there's something you're specifically looking for, because the visual's easiest for me.
The visual's fine. I'll probably go ahead and just... it's untowed today, right?
Should I go fix the Bravo Sagan?
Yeah, we'll go ahead and just take the visual. I believe that's uncontrolled field today, yeah?
So I go 52 Bravo affirmative. New airport at 12 o'clock, 16 miles report to site.
Yeah, he's 16.
Okay, we'll call inside, show the official Bravo.
Alright. More mixture. Flaps are at 1. Let's go ahead and switch over to the CTAF. Get the wheels down. Slow down a little bit. Reno traffic, Commander 171 Zulu is on about a 3 mile left base for runway 25 at Reno traffic. Right there, theoretically. Take more flaps. We're still pretty high, so once we get around this little ridge here, we should be all right. Good. Sit forward in my seat. Not cheating at all. Hey, Chili Willies. Good evening to you, sir. We're just about to land our commander in Reno. And then I'm going to go back to Tahoe where we started, I think. Just making a little FS Economy coin tonight. Cut in a little bit more. Reno traffic, Commander 171 Zulu is on a 1 mile final for runway 25 at Reno. I'm doing well, sir. Thank you very much for asking. I'm in the middle of a extremely busy week at work, but the schedule worked out to get a stream in tonight, so keeping it simple, keeping it light, still a little relaxing, and it's a beautiful... beautiful day all over the west of the U.S. Everything is clear skies and no wind and no precipitation or anything, so I decided we'd just go do some FSE and look at some scenery, pretty much. Laughlin to Palomar, huh? Nice. I've been to Carlsbad Airport. It's very nice. I saw my first Piaggio at Carlsbad in person. Those are some sweet planes. On the center line here, just for novelty's sake. Bunk. Running out of power a little bit there, but that's alright. Supposed to have a wind right down the runway, but instead we had a crosswind. I don't know if it shifted or if Exenviro was just being unkind to us. But let's get this Tokyo Drift plane here slowed down. There we go. I had my feet all the way on the pedals and the brakes triggered, which made us drift the runway a little bit. So, Chili, my friend, did you buy your flights for FlightSimCon? Because I know you were talking about the hotel. I was curious if you had booked it already. Yeah, that taxi was not great, but it's because I was doing a bunch of other things and not paying attention. Says to Rox, thank you for the host, sir. Appreciate that. We're going to do a quick turn here on the ground at Reno and then get on our way again. Just going over to the ramp here. And Reno traffic, Commander 171 Zulu's clear of runway 25. We're taxiing to Jet West. The Tammy episodes are some of my favorite episodes. Megan Mullally is amazing. But yeah, we got Ron Swanson doing the notifications for us. He's my spiritual advisor, life coach, inspiration. Oh yeah, still trying to figure out the flights. Okay, well I just got mine. So that's my announcement for the evening is I'm officially going to FlightSimCon. I'll be flying across the country on Friday and from Portland to Dallas and Dallas to Bradley. And then on Monday, I'm flying back out of Boston because all the departures out of Bradley were red-eye garbage. So I'm going to drive from Hartford to Boston and catch a flight out of Logan back to Portland through San Francisco. Yeah, Boston to San Francisco to Portland. So yeah, get to meet some folks. I believe we will have a PilotEdge booth. Keith was telling me that he's thinking about it, so I'll be certainly hanging around there and hopefully get a chance to meet some folks. All right, let's go ahead and park this thing and get our FSC car.
Reno traffic, Chieftain Charlie, go fix Lulu Bravo. We're overhead the field. We're 8,100 feet. We're going to be making a left turn, descending dead side, joining midfield crosswind for runway 25. Reno traffic.
Holy smokes, that was a lot of words, dude. Park it across five spaces. You got it, buddy. You know it. All right, we need to turn our engines off. And finish. Cool. Now, how much did we make with that, 10-minute in the air flight? Answer, $3,175. Nice. Now, we're going to go right back where we started. I have no rented aircraft. Right. But now. There we go. Okay. Passengers. Yeah, I know. The short flights on FSE are the way to do it. The long ones are... The money does not scale very well with the time invested. It's the short point-to-point, 6 to 10 passenger loads that make money. Which is why I bought a Commander on FSE and why I am enjoying flying this model. It is a great moneymaker. But we're going to go back to Tahoe. Parking brake is set. Gas is fine. Let's go ahead and give it some throttle and restart here. So for the departure out, I'm going to go back to runway 25, we'll turn left, and basically fly the reverse of what we did. Come down here until we're over Washoe Lake, and then cut across to get to Lake Tahoe, and then a straight in to the airport over there. Pretty straightforward. But because we have another aircraft running around Reno airspace, I do want to grab a map and make sure we know where we are and where they are, where everyone is. All right, we're at this
traffic. Chieftain, Charlie Golf, Eagle Bravo, we're overhead the field, 6,000 feet. We're going to be making left downwind midfield. We're joining a left downwind from a midfield crosswind for runway 25, full stop.
All right, so we need to go across the runway, or we can take the long way around and not interfere with this guy's plans. But it looks like now might be the time to do it. Or I think we can go... Well, shoot. Yeah, we should cross runway 7 while he's still overhead. Alright. Turn! Let's go. This thing has, like, no turning radius. It's one of the odd parts of the flight model. So, we just YOLO'd our way through that fence there. But that's fine. Screw that fence. Exactly.
Yeah, radio traffic, Chief and Charlie Golf, Fixable Bravo. We are downwind, full stop, runway 25. Reno traffic.
Reno traffic, Commander 171 Zulu's northbound on Alpha. We're going to cross runway 725 here in about 15 seconds, and we'll report clear.
Okay, I'll keep an eye out for you, Charlie Golf, Fixable Bravo.
Sure he's not warping his way. Yeah. Good to go. Alright. Rear traffic commander 171 Zulu's clear of runway 25. We'll be crossing 34 left and 34 right eastbound on Lima, and we'll hold short of 25 to wait for arriving traffic. Reno. So there's the Chieftain.
Reno traffic, Chieftain, Charlie Golf, Eagle Bravo. We're turning final, runway 25, Reno traffic.
It's perfectly understandable. DCS and X-Plane are like... I don't know a good way to put it, but they're about as different as two things can be and both be about the same general concept. Like, they're both generally about aircraft and flying, and beyond the planes having engines and flight controls and ailerons and elevators and rudders, that's about it as far as the similarity and the knowledge transfer, so it's totally fine. It has been cool to see you... pick it up though, Jilly. I'm glad that you're doing
traffic, Chief and Charlie, go fix the bro. We're short final, runway 25, we're in your traffic.
Let's go ahead and slow this thing down. We can watch our friend the Chieftain here make a nice landing. Throw on the brake and we can watch him. Nice job. Not bad at all. Chili, I booked with Alaska directly because I was using miles. I was using frequent flyer miles on an award ticket, so. That limited my options, but it's also pretty expensive, so it was a good time to use some of those miles I've been saving up. Alright, we'll hold here for a sec.
Reno traffic, Chief and Charlie, go fix the Bravo. We're exiting 25 on Alpha. We'll taxi Alpha Lima to the ramp. Good day.
Skip lagged is another good one, yeah, for doing oddball itineraries. Reno traffic, Commander 171 Zulu is departing runway 25. We'll depart to the south. Reno traffic. I had to think about which direction we were going there for a minute. All right. Transponder's fine, lights are fine, trim's fine, flaps are set. Let's roll. These runways are gigantic for our little commander. But yeah, Flight SimCon, I'm stoked. I got the hotel set up, I got the car for driving back on Monday. Gonna be able to go see a friend on Monday who lives in the Hartford area on my way down to Boston. And I'm stoked. I've never been to Connecticut at all. I've really not spent very much time in the northeast of the US at all. I've been to Philly a couple times, hated it. Been to Burlington, Vermont once last year, loved it. Burlington was awesome. But it'll be my first time in Boston and my first time in Connecticut, Hartford. So yeah, first time in Massachusetts and Connecticut, and then the first time in the cities too, obviously. So should be fun. I haven't really looked at the schedule to see who's presenting. Like, I don't know what the content is. I'm mostly just gonna I want to go hang out with streamers and the GSA folks that I know will be there, and Keith. I think I've mentioned this before, but Keith and I have worked together on we've known each other for something around 12-ish years, and we've specifically worked together on PilotEdge since 2010, and we've spent 2 days in each other's physical company, and the entire rest of the time we've been working remotely from each other. We hung out for a couple days in California like 4 years ago. And that was it so far. So it'll be fun to get to hang out with him a little bit. And we talk all the time on the phone, but I'm sure there will be beers. And I already told Kat that I owe him at least like 5 beers. So we may have a problem in that regard. Not excited about the flight back. Boston to San Francisco is apparently a 6.5-hour flight, which sounds long, but hopefully it won't be too bad. It'll be my first time on Virgin America on that flight, so that'll be fun. All right, so this is Washoe Lake, if I'm not mistaken, according to our sectional. Yep, looks good. So once we get high enough to cross this ridge, we should be able to duck over here and be over the lake. But yeah, for booking travel, I usually use Kayak. Google Flights is fine. couple airlines don't show up on search engines, like Southwest. But in this case, that probably doesn't help you very much. I'm not sure Southwest flies to Hartford, but it's always worth checking on their site before booking anything. But yeah, I fly Alaska a lot because I live in Portland, and they fly a ton of places direct from Portland, and I have elite status with them now. So I usually just book directly through Alaska, but when I need to search something else, Google Flights, Kayak, freaking guy mentioned Skipped Lagged, which is a great site. Between one of those, hopefully you can find a decent option. The hotel was cheap, which I was pleased to see. Sometimes conference hotels are dumb expensive, but this particular one's only about $115 a night, or like $130 after taxes. Pretty reasonable, so. Alright. Trim for level-ish flight here. Mostly level. That's the airport. Zoom in so you can see it. Right there. A little clearing. See the runway. So this is a short one, for sure. Yes, that would make sense to me, Chili. You can always double check, like when you go to book it, it should have the exact date and time of the flight that you want to take. But yeah, unfortunately for West Coast to East Coast, a lot of the flight options are red eyes, which is annoying if you were like me and have a lot of trouble sleeping on planes. You can sleep on planes, they're great, because you just get in and go to sleep, and when you wake up, you're there. But I can't do it. I've tried many times. So, I have to fly during the day, or be extremely tired when I get there. Which is not really the greatest idea when going to something like FlightSimCon, when the whole point is to be there and have a good time. Let's grab TVL CTAF here. Hopefully this haze clears up as we get a little closer. Yeah, hopefully you can find an itinerary that's not too bad. The other problem with the red eyes that I was finding is they would leave Portland at like 10 p.m. and get to Philadelphia by like 6 or 7 a.m. East Coast time, and then the next flight from Philadelphia to Bradley or wherever wasn't for another like 7 hours. So you're sitting in the Philadelphia airport, which is a hellhole to begin with. You're on not great sleep, and you've got to kill like 7 hours. That is not fun. But those flights are often cheap, so there's something to be said for it for sure. Lake Tahoe traffic, Commander 171 Zulu is about 10 miles to the north. We'll be shooting a straight in approach for runway 18 Tahoe. It's not really an approach, I guess. But we're just going to land on the runway that's in front of us. That's what we're going to do. Whatever words I need to use to communicate that that's what's going to happen. It's the elevation of this airport? 6,200. After this, I'm not sure where to go next. TVL has a couple FS Economy legs. I suppose we could just run some of those. But I will take nominations. There's a particular destination of interest. I suppose we could go to Executive. We could go to the new PilotEdge bonus field. Do some IFR. That might be fun. Slow down. Sister Rooks, have a good night, sir. Thanks for the host. Thanks for bringing your crew on by. Have a good night, my friend. Alright. Trim up a little. Flaps out. This plane slows down in a hurry once the flaps come out. That for sure. Same with the gear. It's a very efficient and aerodynamic aircraft until you get the flaps and gear out, and then it turns into a lead balloon. Which I guess is a good thing. It's probably safer that way. The minute you put the flaps out, the nose just goes up immediately. It's like the design of this plane. Everything that's supposed to do a thing does its thing really well. Like, the flaps immediately give you more lift and a slower stall speed. But as soon as they get pulled in, like, the plane just immediately speeds up. This is a fun plane to fly. If you are looking for a general aviation plane, especially if you want to do FS Economy short runs like I'm doing tonight, I would highly recommend this one. It is a lot of fun. Yeah, freaking guy, I hear you. I think that's a worthy cause to save your dollars for. I do want to. I want to try and do something for Simmers on the West Coast at some point. I need to see if I can find a couple other people who are interested in organizing with me, co-organizing something. Because it is kind of lame that the one big Simmers event in the U.S. every year is way up in the Northeast. Pretty far from those of us in the West Coast. There's just cool aviation stuff here. We have Boeing in Seattle. We could do factory tours. We've got the Spruce Goose at the museum here in Oregon. Crazy good aviation museum. Yeah, exactly. PNW, NorCal, something. We should be able to put something together. Even if it's not as big as Flight SimCon. Just something where we can get together and hang out, talk about airplanes. Sounds good to me. I overleaned the engine there and lost all my power. That was exciting. It was just getting slower and slower, and I was like, what is wrong? It's not icing. I hope. Oh, Joe the Bro suggests Florida as well. That's a good call. Yeah, there's a lot of aviation activity, a lot of flight training in Florida. So that would be another good area to have a Simmers event. We should just have one in every corner of the country. Southwest, Northwest, Southeast, Northeast. I would go to Northwest and Southwest for sure. Yeah, Florida's not the greatest climate in the world, that's for sure. All right. Still a little bit high. These displaced thresholds always throw me off. They throw off my sight picture quite a bit. There we go. There's a decent landing, finally. Quanadin, hello. Good evening, my friend. Hope everything is well up the river where you are. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, freaking guy, I agree. I think Sacramento might be perfect. Let us do this. There's some FS Economy passengers who want to go to Sacramento Mather. I don't know how you say it. The big airport there. So let's load those guys up and we'll take them at least as far as Executive. We'll park here next to our Air France CRJ. Very realistic. Right. There we go. Brake on. Engines off. Finish the flight. Did we make this time? $2,268 for a 25-minute flight. All right, let's get these jerks who want to go to Sacramento on board. Still have 86 gallons of fuel. Let's see how far it is over to Executive. Yeah, 74 miles. Oh, sorry. No, these passengers don't want to go to Mather. They want to go to Sacramento International. Yeah. All right, well, we'll take them to Executive for now. So we can do one of two ways. we can go VFR over the out of the mountains here and across the most exciting plains in the world. Try really hard not to land it landed. Mather and land an executive. Or we can try and put together an IFR flight plan. Fly the departure procedure out of Tahoe. And I guess probably Truckee down Victor 6 would make the most sense for an IFR plan. I don't know. What do you guys think? IFR, VFR? I'll start the plane while we think about it. VFR will definitely be faster. We'll get on the ground that much faster. But if it would be interesting to see IFR from Tahoe to SAC Executive, I wouldn't. I'm happy to do it. Quantadin says VFR all the way. No point on this nice day. I agree, sir. Well said. Let's make sure it's nice in Sacramento. Oh yeah, clear skies. No sweat. Cool. Alright, so that means all we have to worry about is we have to get over the terrain, and then we need to stay out of the Sacramento Mather Class Delta, which goes up to 2,600. You can see the 2.6 there. And then we'll just go over to SAC Executive. VFR it is. Exactly. Exactly. Get my charts for Mather here. We didn't really do much CTAFing on our way in here, did we? Oh well. They'll live. Alright, flaps. Trim for takeoff. Passengers are loaded. Fuel should be fine. We can always land and get more if we need it. Let's roll. Break off. Turn this beast. Ugh. Oh, you know what? Yeah. Hi, CRJ. Sorry, my plane can't turn very fast, so we're just gonna go by you real quick. Probably could have turned the other way. Let me go ahead and file to the brake. And we will file. Hitting the brake pretty much just makes it stop. Like, it doesn't turn too much sharper. Passengers are all set. Thank you for the reminder, but we got all these fools. And also looks like one person who thinks they're going to Reno. Ha! Got news for you, buddy. We're not going Reno. We're going farther from the Reno. Alright. Yeah, in real life the tow brakes will do, but here, watch. Like, when I hit it, it does turn the plane faster, but it also, like, comes to a stop pretty hard as well, so it's hard to do a continuous turn using the tow brakes. But we can try it up here, and it definitely does tighten the turning radius. I've powered it pretty hard through a turn with the brakes, and then you just drift it, which is also kind of fun, but... I've not been able to flip it over yet on the tight turns, but all right, Flaps are good, trim's good, lights are good. Transponders. Still set. This is a piston aircraft. Not the fastest thing in the skies, but it's kind of fun to fly. Yeah, non-turbocharged exactly. All right. Yeah, so there's a turn with the brake, and you can see it does turn quite a bit, but it also stops the aircraft, even though I'm only using one brake. Lake Tahoe Traffic Commander 171 Zulu's departing runway 36 will be departing to the southwest, Lake Tahoe. Get our navigation set up once we get in the air. Yeah, there's some crazy videos out there of Bob Hoover flying this plane and doing aerobatics. They hired him to demonstrate the plane. I don't know the full story of why, but I think it was because it was like perceived as too boring. So yeah, he would do rolls, power off, exactly. He would do power off engine loops. Like he made this plane do some crazy stuff for a like cabin class piston twin that was used for hauling rich people around. That was Bob Hoover. That was just kind of what he did. But yeah, YouTube Bob Hoover Commander. There's some crazy stuff. All right, flaps are in. Set up for 100 knots. All right, Sacramento VOR is just to the southwest of the field, so we'll use that. Get over the mountains here. Looks like around 10,000 is the highest peak. So we'll just kind of chill. Northwestish until we can make it. But yeah, basically we'll just turn through there. I haven't seen him pouring a cup of tea in a barrel roll, but I can believe that he could do it. I'll have to watch that one. I wanted to include a clip of him in my video. I'm doing a review of this plane. I'm putting together a video of it, and I was trying to figure out if there was any footage of him that I could use that was not, whether I could use just a little bit, that it was fair use, or what the deal is. But I might just have to link to it. But yeah, he did some pretty epic things in this thing. All right, so if we get up to 11,000, we should be fine. Yeah, it's on YouTube, it's just not... I don't want to take someone else's video. I was hoping there might be some stuff that was old enough to be in public domain, but it's not that old. If we get lost, there's another VOR on the way, too. That we could tune into. Hangtown. VR. Kind of a funny name. We can go ahead and turn here. by the time we get over there, and I think that's the 10K peak right there. And we're just passing through 10 right now. Climb a little more. Yeah, man, go ahead. Go ahead and post that, that'd be great. Thanks for asking, but yeah, I don't mind links usually. No, Nightbot does not, doesn't kick people for links. You're good. Iowa Flyer, hello, good evening, sir. Hope you are doing well. We're just doing some VFR on a day that is extremely nice. My efforts to try and find some bad weather to fly around in were thwarted by nice weather all over the PE area. So we decided we would just do some VFR, go visit the new bonus field, hang out for a little bit. All right, I'm going to level off here. Ah, the T-port barrel roll. I'm going to throw it on autopilot for just a sec so I can watch that myself. Come on. Just grabbing the radial. All right, good. All right, I want to see this.
I had Secretary of the Air Force, Gene Sukert, in co-pilot seat. And he had the aft part of the airplane filled with the generals. And he said, Bob, can the airplane be rolled? And I said, yes, sir. And I rolled, and the generals were all having a cup of coffee, and none of them spilled a drop. And then I got so bold as to think that maybe I could even pour iced tea.
That's so funny.
So then we put it on film. Now, the difficult thing to think about is try to pour backhanded. See it on camera.
What?
Believe it or not, you can see the horizon going around as the tea is poured into the glass.
That's amazing. Physics at work. Exactly right. Exactly. Totally agreed. All right, about 22 minutes. So saith the DME. Pull it back off of AP here. Yeah, Bob Hoover was one hell of a pilot. There's no doubt about that. I just think the very idea of a aircraft company hiring essentially a stunt pilot to demonstrate your business aircraft, like, that's just not a thing that would ever happen. That was a different time, for sure. Yeah, exactly. Ex-combat pilot, ex-stunt pilot, or current stunt pilot, really, flying in air shows in a business aircraft. Not even a stunt plane. Yeah, I think I've heard that story as well, that he wanted him to do 707 tests, and that, like, he wanted to do rolls and stuff in the 707, and Boeing was like, yeah, sure, why not? And insurance was like, maybe not. And darn insurance ruins everything. All right. So, remember, we need to stay up above 2600, but we can start slowly descending here. That's fine. We don't need to be all the way up here. Doing a cool almost 200 over the ground here. Not bad. Not bad at all. Yeah, Yeah, I'm sure someone rolled a 707 at some point. That was still back in the good old days of aviation where you could do crap like that. Would not fly these days, not one bit. Alright, altimeter for Sacramento is 3034. Let's go ahead and get that in there. Close enough. Tower's on 119.5. Let's go ahead and dial that up. We won't need them for a while. But listen at least. Yeah, 19.5. For some reason that I don't understand, Sacramento Executive has 3 runways. And I have no idea which one to expect. We'll be coming in from the northeast, so could be anything. But we'll try and make sense out of whatever instructions we're given. Yeah, I'm pleased with this. This is Zoom level 17. I bought new hard drives specifically for the purposes of being able to up from 16 to 17. Get my mixture in real quick. There we go. We're losing our power there again. And yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. It makes this kind of lowish and slowish flying a lot of fun when you have something to look at. That is for sure. Yeah, Iowa Flyer. I have not tried any... Can't say I've tried any aerobatics in this thing. I don't know the first thing about actual aerobatic flying, but I do enjoy this plane. I enjoy this model of it quite a bit. I've always liked commanders. I used to have one for FS 2002, I think. I had a commander that I would tootle around in. But yeah, it's a fun plane. Hopefully I'll get my video review of this finished this week. I got all the footage for it. I got the script written. I just need to record the voiceover and do all the editing together of all the clips and balance all the sound and everything. But I am a fan. The Shoop Aero Commander. That sounds familiar. That sounds very familiar. Yeah, the crosswind is coming and going. It was 40 knots a minute ago, and now it's 3. So that's why the plane's like, whoa, what's going on? It doesn't really matter. I'm not on a particular course. I'm just trying to go straight to Sacramento. So, yep, Milton Shoop. That sounds accurate. I also saw Carinato's working on a 690 commander for FSX, so maybe that one will come to X-Plane as well. It'd be cool to have the turboprop version of this plane. There is a turboprop commander. I don't remember the number designation for it, but they made one with two turbos. That'd be fun. Loading tiles. transitioning from the beauty of Tahoe to the boringness of Sacramento here. This isn't even turbocharged. This is just piston. I think the 690 is supercharged. But this one isn't even that, as far as I know. Yeah, straight old school, exactly. Now, this plane was designed in, like, the 40s. Like, look at this yoke column here. Like, that is not how modern plane controls look at all. Even the, like, kind of rounded panel instead of the squared-off panel. I mean, the cabin looks fairly contemporary. But, yeah, This is not a modern plane by any stretch, but it is fun. I think it holds up really well. When you consider that this thing probably was like, I think they started making it in like 44 or something like that. Yeah, the 680 was designed in the mid-50s and is the turbocharged piston. This is the older one. I don't know exactly when this was introduced, but it's something around the 40s or 50s, so it's somewhere between 60 and 70 years old as a design. Which is kind of nuts. 54, there you go. Not 44. Yeah, 44 would be a little old. I do not have any scenery for Sacramento Executive. From what I have heard on the PilotEdge Discord, there is not a ton to be had. Like, I think there's one package and it's not particularly interesting. So, I don't know if we should expect any buildings at all. My guess is no. But we'll let this thing continue descending. Altitude-wise, yeah, Executive's at like 24 feet. So, got some descending we can do safely here. Yeah, I think I said it earlier, but this plane is an excellent, excellent moneymaker on FSE. It holds 7 people.
American 21 Optics Center, descend via the Hyder 1 arrival for runway 25 left.
I don't really know why in FSE it holds 7 people, but it does, and it's perfect for those little, like, under 100 nautical mile runs that people set up with their passenger terminals on FSE. So, Megamoss, hello, good evening, sir. Hope you are well. Miles to the Sacramento VOR. The airport is located to the northeast a little bit. So, yeah, you can do longer flights in this plane for sure. It's not the fastest thing in the world, though. So, once you get above 100 nautical miles, the profit per hour drops off pretty sharply. It's much better in this plane to do the short runs. Megamoss, I'm doing excellent. Thank you for asking, sir. It's been a busy week at work writing performance reviews for all my folks that I manage. So it is a good night to take a little midweek break and relax with some flight sim. This is the Carinato Aero Commander 500. Same plane I flew the other day on stream that you were watching. Yeah, it'll cruise. With a decent wind, you can get a ground speed over 200 in this thing at altitude. So it's not super slow. It's just the way FS Economy is set up, the profit on longer jobs is, it does not scale well. Like, it's kind of busted. short flights are way more... the money you make from short flights is way more profitable if you can fly for a couple hours than it is for the long flights. So that's why a lot of people have legs set up in FS Economy. They're really short, like 20 nautical mile. Oh, yes. Thrilling Sacramento area. So much to see. So much to do. All right, so we're going to fly over the top of Mather. We need to stay out of their delta. So, we'll stay up above 2600. Yeah, 100 to 150 exactly. We have not contacted NorCal, nor should we hopefully have to. We will be going straight to Sacramento Executive Tower, because we should not be clipping the Sacramento International, Charlie. I don't know. Yeah, you can see the ring here. I think that's the ring for the Charlie. We'll keep an eye on it as we get closer. But no, I have the radio tuned for Executive for when we get there. But we will chill out right about 4,500. This is perfect. Just a delta. And it doesn't even underlie the International Charlie. It's just south of it. You can see the outer shelf here only goes to 1600. So it's pretty well set up to allow planes to be in the pattern for Executive without infringing on Sacramento International at all.
Phoenix clearance, SkyWest 4003 IFR to Las Vegas, please.
That sounds like Max. I'm not mistaken.
Scott 4003, Phoenix, Las Vegas, we can in left airport, Mesa 5 departure, assisted transition, then it's file, climb via SID, squawk 7461.
Okay, we're cleared to Las Vegas, Mesa 5 departure, assisted transition, then it's file, climb via SID, squawk 7461.
Scott 4003, read back correct.
You can see, you can turn right just a little bit here and go direct, but there's the outline of the Charlie there. So basically we just have to get over Mather's Delta, which is that circle there, and then we can descend. But we're just going to basically fly right over the top of it here. Leave this up for a little bit. Thing has so much power that it just wants to climb all the time. I've pushed the trim down like four times. Normal radius on a delta is 5 miles. So once we get clear of the meter one here, we can pretty much call any time, I suppose. Executive Tower Commander 171 Zulu is about 8 miles east, full stop.
Number 171 Zulu, Executive Tower, enter left base runway 20, report turning final.
Okay, well, we'll start at a left base for runway 20, and we'll report final, Commander 171 Zulu, and we have Alpha. Alright, so we can descend now. So 20 is basically the runway that's the most aligned with where we are. That should work out just fine. Let's see if we can see the airport yet. Yeah, right there, right in front of us. And as I suspected, we have no scenery whatsoever. So I'm going to pull the power out here and let this thing slow down. Yeah, I like this model a lot. I'm enjoying it for sure. GPS now. By the time we get down low enough, we will be clear of the delta for Mather, so go ahead and come down quite a bit. Is that SMF over there? Yeah. Can't really see it. I think it's a little farther north, so. Yeah, good day for a little VFR cross country, that's for sure. Hello, wind. Okay, throw some flaps out. That will help us slow down. Gear down. Yes, I am using Axibara. Yep. Got a mixture all the way in. 2/3 flaps. Land right over there. Sending pretty fast, but that's okay. I'll slow down a little bit and see if we can halt our rate of descent a little bit here. We're sort of not really squaring off this base leg at all, but that's alright. Executive Tower Commander 171 Zulu's turning final for runway 20.
71 Zulu, runway 20, clear land.
Clear land 20, 171 Zulu. Not the straightest final ever, but we're low and slow, so who cares? This is like how they land in Hawaii with the airliners, because they fly the inter-island 717s all day. The pilots are so used to the routes that they can make these like crazy sharp patterns. And they basically roll it out on final with like a 2 mile final or something like that, like really, really close. Interesting experience as a passenger, if you know enough about aviation to recognize a close pattern when you see one. Freaking guy asks when the next 12-hour mega stream is. Well, let's see. I've been married for 12 years. Took 12 years to get one. So, let's see. Do the math. Carry the one. That would make it 2029. Will be the next one. Well, I'll take that all day long. That might have been our best landing so far. Get this thing parked and we can go watch that one again. We'll bask in the glory of that one a little bit. That is for sure. Executive Commander 171 Zulu, we'd like to go straight ahead on Hotel Juliet Hotel to the ramp.
71 Zulu Hotel to the ramp. G'day.
G'day.
Alright, flaps. Alaska 511 descended maintain travel 240.
Yeah, that was 174 feet per minute. 1.5 G. Might be the best one I've had in this plane yet. Let's park here. Here's fine. Engines off. Port the flight. Sorry to all those passengers who thought they were going to Sacramento International. You, in fact, went to Sacramento Executive. Bad news for you. We will disconnect from PE.
Disconnected.
And let's watch this one again. 79 FPM, not bad. I've only gotten it down to double digits a couple times, to be honest with you. But like Valdude says, it's more about the G rate than it is the feet per minute. So let's do this. Let's go into floating camera mode. And touchdown looked like it was right about here. Yeah, buddy. I always need to flare more in this plane. It doesn't feel like it will flare as much. We definitely flew it into the ground rather than letting it settle, but not too bad. All right, I am going to call it a night, I think. Wife will be home soon, and there's a couple other people streaming, so I'm going to throw it over to JSnap1982. We're going to go join his Justin's stream. So I'll drop his link here, and we can all go over and tell him a hearty hello from Tim, if you would. Appreciate that. But yeah, thanks for joining me. Had a good time. See you soon.